filling the cryostat with the liquid helium.
Do you want to see helium go superfluid?
Yeah.
You have like 5 minutes.
Can you fill the cryostat first?
Yeah, I'm trying to record it with my camera.
Okay.
Dima wants to put a video or something.
About 5 minutes?
Yeah.
I'm gonna feel it for 2 more minutes.
Okay.
And then I have to pump on it.
So, do you figure out the pumping problem?
It was, I think, a heat load problem. So, we should have a picture. There are radiation shields along this insert.
Uh-huh.
And this one came with 3 inserts already installed, 3 shields installed, and I thought that was enough.
Okay.
But I guess it wasn't. That had a pair of 4 shields, and I've installed them all of this insert.
Okay.
And so, I, yeah.
Wow, I can see like convective.
You mean here?
Is that heat?
No, it's just helium coming out.
It looks like what you normally associate with hot air.
Yeah, because it goes up.
Yeah.
It's a cold air, but helium's
helium
so light.
Yeah.
Yeah. So you can actually do this.
My name is Mickey Mouse.
Can you hit off your cryostat?
Yeah.
So that's right now that's liquid?
Yeah. It was at the top just about a minute and a half ago. So I'm going to let it fill for 30 more seconds and then close the valve. And
so right now, is it still boiling?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So what happened when it goes superfluid?
It still boils, but you just can't see it because it has, I think, really high thermal conductivity.
Hmm.
So any evaporation happens at the surface.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah, that's when you can see that it's going superfluid.
Okay.
So I'm gonna close it and.
There you go, the other guys.
Yeah. Okay. Reconnect the pump. It's gonna take about a minute from now. Okay. I haven't figured out if I use only one of the 2 pumps, it will still work. I guess I can do it later. This is the configuration I know it works in. I'm just gonna keep pumping. The thermometer is a little bit off, so it goes superfluid when that one reads 1.95 or so. So you can sort of look here, take a set if you want.
This one up here?
Yeah. The one on the right, B, when it reads 1.95 or so, that's when it goes superfluid.
Can you see it from the side? Is there anything to see?
I think it lasted for about 3-4 minutes before I ran out of it. Well, technically, for one that's usable for data. If that were correct, it should be superfluid now, but it's old by a little.
What's the electrification
for? It's some sort of diode, semiconductor sensor. It's not thermocouple effect, it's something else.
But there's no contact with the EA.
It should be. Maybe a few. So light doesn't really scatter to the side. So it's it does look better. When you're looking like that. I hope it's not stuck here. I'm not sure why it looks stuck there. This was the problem I was having before. Yeah, it's not going any down. Let's see what am I doing wrong? This is the only connection I've broken and lost. Sorry, something went wrong. Not sure what.
So you're pumping out of both pumps?
Yeah, pumping with the both pumps.
Connections tight.
This 6 all the way, okay? So this one actually feels kind of frozen, so...
Yeah. Sealed.
Ooh, okay. It might have been a seal, some sort of a
seal. This actually seems sort of loose here.
Pull them all the way.
Tough hands.
Oh, there you go.
Okay, I'll just hold it like this.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, there's a... seems like there's a leak there.
Yeah.
It's on the rad lab gasket, I guess. I was changing hair tie up. Looks like it's basically an oscilloscope seeing boiling when it is.
Yeah, it's technically still evaporating from the top,
yeah.
But
hair, yeah.
But the entire liquid is at the same temperature.
Cool. Oh.
Yeah.
So just equilibrates from, what's the equilibration time for like this volume?
No, what do you mean?
Like, how... So there's some time it takes, like...
Oh, I don't know. All I know is that thermal conductivity of superfluid helium is really high.
Okay.
So...
Do you want to take a look? Or?
I have the video.
Yeah.
Okay, let's see. Yeah, so I guess I won't actually be able to take additional data since... So maybe that was actually my problem.
Yeah, it still seems... I mean, if you take like a pipe wrench, maybe you can still type it as is.
Nah, it's okay. I kind of have to...
Well, soon too. It seems like I can still see a boiling, like, things...
Pop. Oh yeah, now it shouldn't be superfluid anymore.
Ah, oh, okay,
yeah,
I see.
Because
yeah.
I let it go, so okay. I'm not pumping as well.
Okay.
Anyway, so that's a superfluid transition. I'm just gonna let the system.
So, and now you're trying to measure the current back to
eventually, for today.